It's getting colder. We just It's growing.
Puts us on the same level of animals in a different way than white people did it during slavery. It's more of a connection to nature rather than a reduction of oneself.
So I know. So if anyone ever comes over to my apartment, do not push my books in, because you will be fucking up my system.
Song of Solomon. Oh, this book is crunchy. Doesn't really have a smell. Hello and welcome to a new vlog. Today is the day after Ashton's birthday, so the 2nd. We're kind of celebrating his birthday the whole week. Today's Tuesday. His birthday was on Monday, and like nowhere was that he wanted to go to was open on Monday. Break fast. And then I'm also Beloved on Audible, and I'm actually getting through a bit of it now. I've realized that with this book, because it doesn't have any like specific chapter numbers, or like it's not broken up in the way that a book typically would be. Oven's preheated, I can put the toaster in now. Because it's not broken up in a way that a book typically would be, it was taking me a while to like get through it on Audible, because I couldn't like, on Audible there's no page numbers, it just like reads for a couple hours. I mean for like hours and hours and hours. So what I did, which is exactly what I did with Dorian Gray, and that also helped me finish that book when I was like kind of idling with it, was I went in all the little sections of the book's broken up into, I believe, 3 parts. And so I did it in color. So part 1 is all of the yellow tabs, part 2 is all these pink tabs, and then part 3 is the yellow tabs at the end. And each tab represents a section, or like a chapter, so you say, or where Toni kind of breaks off in the part and like moves on to another part. So like there's this section, and then there's this, oh sorry, there's this section, and then there's like this section, see? But yeah, as you can see, I've started and restarted this book over like 4 times, because I kept losing where I was at, because there is no like structure. However, since I've broken it up, I've realized that it's much, 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 much easier to get through. So I'm really enjoying this, again, as I always do, because Toni is near and dear to my heart. But anyways, I'm gonna listen to this on Audible while I make my breakfast, and then I'm gonna get back to you when I get dressed to go. Also, like look at my face. I didn't do my full like skincare routine that I like normally do today. Like today I just like washed my face with my regular cleanser and moisturized, and I mixed in this vitamin C powder that I got from The Ordinary. And I didn't put on any sunscreen, because my plan was to go for a run when it was dark, but I didn't see that it was snowing. And that kind of fucked me up. So this is just like not my normal skincare, but I'm glowing. Like, I want to get new earrings for this ear, because as you can see, this earring is pretty rusty. And truly, I don't care, but I've been wearing these for like over 4 or 5 years. And these ones I've literally had since I pierced my ears when I was 14. So, I think it's time for some new earrings. Anyways. It's breakfast time. Maybe I'll make another coffee or another tea.
Spent those hours trying to negotiate the weight of her eyelids. She said she was thirsty, but thought better of it. A young colored woman drifting was drifting from ruin. He had been in Rochester 4 years ago.
Okay, so right, I'm preparing chicken for dinner. I cut up a little bit. And
here I have some whole spices that I pounded. And here I have the chicken with some oil and the intestines. And over here I have some garlic and onion that I'm gonna stuff the chicken with, and some celery that I'm gonna use to twine the chicken, because I don't have any kitchen twine. And here we have a long strip of twine.
This is how it looks. Bound.
Welcome back to the kitchen. 4 p.m., 4:03 exact. The chicken has been in the oven for about 50 minutes, almost an hour. I have showered and I washed my hair. Oiled it. Oh, those are my locks.
Yes. Anyone's wondering what they look like?
Next day, Wednesday.
She's not strong. She can hardly walk without holding on to something. That's what I mean.
Okay, so my camera's dying, so I'm gonna update you really quick. It's 3:49. I don't really know what time I checked in before, what time I started reading, but when I did start reading, I think I was on like page 60 or so, and I'm now on page 100. I've read about 1, 2, 3. I'm gonna say it's like 4. 5 or 6 chapter sections, and I'm 30% of the way through the book. I have updated my progress on Goodreads, and so far loving it. Still think that it's easy to get through. Not really easy, it's traumatic. Talks about a lot of trauma and PTSD and mental health issues and depression and loss and whiteness versus blackness, and the effect that whiteness has on the black identity and the psyche and survival of the fittest, human nature, bodies in relation to animals. So it is a lot to stomach, but for me that's not a lot. So I think it's really good. I'm enjoying it. I want to read more right now. I was gonna try and keep going until I finished part one, which ends at page 200. So that would be another 100 pages to read. But I am going out tonight and I want to nap before I go out. So I think I'm gonna maybe nap, or maybe I won't nap. I am a little sleepy, but I'm thinking I could just have coffee. Anyways, that is—
Hello, Sevy Wevy. It is 4:30 p.m. on Saturday, March 11th, and I think I'm gonna take a walk for my mental health. I worked today, and after work, I kind of came home, sat in bed there, and watched some YouTube, which prompted me to fall asleep. So I took a nap, and then I woke up about an hour ago and went into the kitchen and heated up some leftover curry goat and rice. and it was quite delicious. But I think now that I really need to go outside and take a walk, because I'm feeling like I want some fresh air, and I just need to like move my body outside of, you know, work. But a part of me also is doing this because I want to head down to the little library down the street and take some books, because I'm feeling take-ish. I also obviously want to leave some books, but I haven't organized my library yet, and once I do, I know I have a ton of books I want to unhaul, so I'm going to organize my library, drop off some books sometime this week, but today I'm just going to take a walk down there and see what they have, because I need to get outside. It's 44 degrees, so I know it's cold. I think I'm going to put on some sweats and my coat and my headphones and just walk. This is my mental health walk fit. I'm hoping that it's not too cold, but this jacket that I'm wearing underneath keeps me quite warm, and I have this turtleneck, Nike windbreaker pants, and my pajama pants underneath. Welcome back. I just got back from my mental health. I thought that I was, I wanted to read, but I think I want to just sit here, drink my coffee, eat my cookies, and watch some YouTube, and that's what I'm gonna do, and then maybe edit some of this video.
Ending, for a number of reasons, I thought it was really rushed, and everything like suddenly solved itself out of nowhere. All of Marjorie's problems and Wendell's problems.
School teacher, one nephew, one slave catcher, and a sheriff. The house on Bluestone Road was so quiet, they thought they were too late.
So we have gotten to page 200 of Beloved. 200 of Beloved, and that is where chapter 2 starts. I don't know why Toni decided to make the first two-thirds of the book, or the first 200 pages, chapter 1, but it was definitely a tome to get through, a roller coaster of emotions, a lot of history when it comes to slavery. I learned a lot about the real history of slavery and whatnot, which is obviously, I've tabbed up quite a bit. And in terms of the character, story characters, it's like finally starting to blend. I've reached the point where, I don't know the guy's name. There's a guy. Stamp paid was showing Paul D a newspaper clipping of a woman who I guess is, they're looking for her because she committed a crime, and he's trying to convince him that it's Setha, and he's like, no, that can't be Setha, that's not her mouth. And then he obviously can't read the newspaper article, so he asks Setha if it's true, and she pretty much tells him the truth about the article, and he can't stand it, so he decides that after all of this time he's going to leave her and her children, although he said that he would never leave her.
all because he can't handle the grief or negative associations that come with whatever it is that the white people said that she did in order to keep her children from being enslaved. So that's where we're at. And at the very end of part one, Seth, he says, like, put away some supper for me, I'll be back soon. And Seth is like, he's so stupid, he thinks I can't handle him saying goodbye. Because he thinks that after everything that I've told him, that saying goodbye would break me. And he is, you know, trying to protect her. And under her breath, she goes, so long, because she knows that he's leaving. And that is where part two starts. Toni? So much world building in this book, so much history, so many amazing great characters. It kind of scared me at some points. It is sci-fi, and again, Seth is being haunted by the ghost of her dead daughter, who I think she murdered in order to keep her free. And then the ghost grew up and came back to haunt her as an adult, but she's not seeing it as a ghost, she's seeing it as a grown woman whom she has taken in to love. Although the ghost has some sort of a vengeance and is trying to push Pauly out of the home, which I guess she has finally succeeded in doing. But, yeah, but this book is a lot. I'm loving it. I'm enjoying it. I want to finish it, but it is 11 p.m. Oh, it's actually 12.
So, man, right the time, gonna go back or forward?
Oh, shit.
Is that today?
I don't know. That is soon. It's 11:58 on March 11th. Oh, and, I've finished two-thirds of this book. I'm so happy. I'm making progress considering the fact that I just restarted this like a couple days ago and already read 200 pages. Thank you, Seven. You're killing it.
I'm losing an hour of sleep. Sorry, vlog. Okay.
I have 100 pages left and I reckon that I will finish this in about 2 days. Although the next part two, seems to be like much bigger than the final part, which seems to be about 20 pages. So it looks like this first part is separated. It's about 80 pages, and this is about like 20 or 30 pages. So I don't really know how, I mean, I can definitely finish part two in a day, but it's just setting my mind to it. But that's beloved, that's all that I've read tonight and all the updates and how it's going. So far there's tons of overarching themes of freedom, the existence of black bodies and how they're allowed to exist only by whiteness, the concept of freedom, denial, grief, identity, understanding self, human nature, lots of allusions and references to animals, stripping away oneself.
Wait, what?
Stripping away one's identity and comparing it to, or keeping it on the same level or a lesser level of animals. And I find naturally just in life that there's, like humans choose to separate themselves from animals, but Toni in this book puts us on the same level of animals in a different way than white people did it during slavery. It's more of a connection to nature rather than a reduction of oneself. But yeah, love this book. Classic, iconic, queen, love her. Everyone should be reading Toni Morrison, and that is my goal with this vlog. So that's all I got to say for tonight, because Ashton has something he really wants to say. Hello, and welcome to another day of I don't know what to eat, so I am making everything in my fridge in one. And on today's episode of that, we're making a chicken soup. Jalapeno pepper, celery, mushroom, and then the leftover sauce that was at the bottom of the pot from when I roasted chicken, because this was the pan that this chicken was in when it was in the fridge. So I just kind of took the chicken out, left the juices at the bottom, sauteed everything in the juices, and now we're gonna deglaze the pan with some water because we are making soup. Don't complain about the fact that there's no carrots in here. I'm literally out.
Staying connected. The world evolved, and those connections became simpler.
Oh, blog. Video. Seven. Whoever. is watching. I've been deliberating for about 2 hours. My edges are like, my forehead is like giant. Not that I don't love my giant forehead, but I prefer when my hair looks like this, thank you. Because it's looking kind of flat because I had a hat on. But anyways, I've been deliberating for a couple hours about whether or not I should deal with the problem. I'm almost done, and like looking at this pile, my camera's kind of dirty. I really truly don't think that I have that many books. That's all I have left. My Penguin collection. I've got it somewhat organized and down to ish, kind of, sort of, how I kind of like, I think I want it. I was done, which is good because I have 1, 2, 3, 4 more to fill up. And this is all of my fiction slash stories, collections of short stories. Those are books I'm giving away. I still need to go through this and pick out the ones I want to give away. And these are most of my classics and plays and anything Greek. And by classics, I mean what the world considers classic literature, because those are also classics. So I think I want to put the classics up here. Because although I thought I had more classic literature, I don't. But I can fit maybe all of my classics up here on my Toni Morrison shelf. And then I think I can put all of my fiction, like contemporary fiction and stories and stuff. I don't really know. We're gonna see. I don't know how long this took because I didn't record. I didn't like time myself, but here is the reveal. I wish it was like cuter. Like I mean it's gonna be a lot cuter eventually. What's important is that my shelves are organized. So this is a random shelf, not really a part of these. These are all of my new arrivals slash some gifts that Courtney brought me back from Africa. Africa. I don't know why I said it that way. These are books I'm currently reading, books I finished and that I need to write about. Random things, and then these are some extra art related books that don't fit on that shelf over there. And then the breakdown of this is up here we have all of my magazines and photo albums, record player, more photos. These are all of my Penguin classics. These are my Little Black classics, and then other just Penguin classic books. I thought I had more than this, but I don't, which is good because I now have room to buy more, but I won't. And I just have two journals here. This second shelf is all contemporary fiction, as well as this third shelf, also contemporary fiction. And just this stack here are all like collections of stories or anthologies. And then on the lower shelf, we have my children's literature, which I thought I had more of this also, but I don't. Harry Potter collection gifted to me by April. So this is children's and also a little bit of YA fiction. There might be, I doubt it, but there might be one YA book like stuck in this mix that shouldn't be there. But I have some Goosebumps up here. Yeah, more YA fiction and children's lit, and then a few children's books that I have over there. And then at the bottom is where we get into like school, I guess. Because here I have my small dictionary collection, some books on literature, some books on like textbooks from college, so communications work, a random book on drugs or pills, some history books and textbooks, social sciences, and psych science. So yeah, science. There's lots of history and science down here. And then if we just go right on over here,
to the bottom shelf, we're going to see that we have more history books. So these are more like historical essays. And then from there, we move on into a little bit more historical essays, but like they're kind of specific. And then over here, we have collections of essays that people have written. So like shorter essay works as opposed to these, which ones are giant tomes. Up here, I think I just have some history books, like some Rome history books. And then to the end of this shelf, you will find all of my philosophy. And the books that poke out separate the genres, so I know. So if anyone ever comes over to my apartment, do not push my books in, because you will be fucking up my system. But philosophy. And then we move up one shelf, and here you will find all of my... I like that each genre also, like, fit perfectly, or I found a way to make them fit perfectly on the shelves. But up here on this shelf, we have all of my memoirs, and then here, Jhené Aiko starts all of my poetry. So this is my small collection of poetry, which is not that small, because I do have some smaller poetry books that are, like, stuffed in there. It looks like there's not many, but there's, like... three books right there. And then above that is where we get into my classic literature. So I've put sort of like the older, I've kind of sorted it from like older to contemporary. So, but they're not obviously entirely organized by time period, because I didn't feel like it. And I also would rather them be color coordinated and genre coordinated and author coordinated, which you're gonna see. If I have a book by another author, I will put them all together. Like here I have all Toni Morrison, I have some Edith Wharton, some Kate Chopin. Over here we have some Dostoevsky. Over here Shakespeare's only separated because these two books are smaller than this one. But yeah, so we have older classics going into newer, more contemporary classics. Like Kafka, Baldwin, 1984. I know Great Expectations. I mean, A Movable Feast is not supposed to be here, but it just looks better. Yeah. More contemp classics. And then at the very top shelf, this whole stack is all plays. Actually, this whole section here is all plays. I didn't realize how many plays I had. I don't usually read plays, but I have plays. And then my epic stories that I guess are, I don't really know if these are considered plays, but I think that they are, because I've seen them acted out. Yeah, and then I have some Euripides, two copies of the Odyssey, because I accidentally bought this one. Oh, I bought this one fully, and I thought that it came, I don't really know what I thought, but I don't really know what I want to do with this. If anyone reads Greek and wants a copy of books, two books from the Odyssey, that's yours. Let's not step on the stack of books that I'm unhauling. Look at me, unhauling books. Unheard of. I didn't think I was going to get rid of this many. And honestly, I might just give all of these to Shade. But that is my little library. I'll do a better overview when there's sun outside.
It is the next morning, the 3rd, 4th, I don't have my watch on, the 14th, and I had a really crazy dream, and for some reason I can't remember it right now. I remembered it an hour ago when I was actually up, but I can't remember it right now. But can we please talk about the fact that I have this terrible fear that one day I'm going to wake up and take off my bonnet and all of my locks are just going to be sitting in my bonnet, like they've all fallen off of my head. And I don't really know how to deal with that fear except to believe that it won't happen, but it's not possible because it could happen. Like all my hair could fall off, but I doubt it. Vitamin C Shine Tea, and this lime that's sitting in there is the lime that I used for the avocado.
Been downgrading, you know it. Do your best.
I have about 4 or so hours left.
got two Tonys. So we have a Mercy Tony that I got. Oh, not the last. There's obviously more. Is this mass market version copy of Song of Solomon. Oh, this book is crunchy. Doesn't really have a smell or too many word annotations, but we have some underlining going on. Oh, the person who wrote this has their name in the back. I mean, who read it has their name in the back, and another cover for Beloved. Wow, I opened it up and the first line I read is, "But people who lynch and slice off people's balls, they're crazy. Guitar crazy." Guitar crazy. That's funny. There's not much space in the margins for annotations, but I'm not complaining. Okay, put this on my Tony shelf. Things getting colder. We just it's growing. These are my leftovers, or dinner, I guess, from last night, because I ordered takeout and then fell asleep in pain, too much in pain to eat. So that's lunch.
Read like 10 books, which is objective and ever, but especially when it comes to books. If you're reading, you're winning. Two!
Okay. And one other actual thing that I do need to buy. Another one of these. As you can see, my favorite pen is almost out of ink, and this is my only black pen in 0.4. Okay, y'all, I have a minute left of footage, so I'm gonna say this quick. It is 12:43, I guess, on the 15th, the next day, and it's bedtime now. I just showered, brushed my teeth, moisturized, the whole nine yards, and I did not come home from Manhattan today with any books, which is good. All I did was went to Barnes & Noble, I read a little, got some coffees, and I literally mean some coffees, and then when I came home, made dinner, had dinner, we got some special snacks for ourselves, and I ordered the rest of my Toni Morrison collection, because for some reason I thought she only had 7 books, but she has way more than 7 books. So I ordered the rest of her fiction collection and all of her nonfiction. So my next video is going to be an unhaul of these books and a haul on my new arrivals. Thank you for watching. See you soon. Moisturize, brush your teeth, and take your vitamins.